Hi everyone, let's start with new concept, that is fuel air cycles. In last lecture we have studied air standard cycle, or generally we called it as ideal gas cycle. The steps in it were idealized processes and idealized working fluid. Now we will see fuel air cycles, in that we have idealized processes and accurate working fluid. Now, what are contents of air fuel cycle? Factors to be considered while studying air fuel cycles are composition of cylinder gases, variable specific heat, dislocation, number of moles. We will have comparison of air standard cycle with fuel air cycle, and later on we will study the effect of various operating parameters or variables, that is such as compression ratio, fuel air ratio, etc. Now, what is fuel air cycle? Fuel air cycle can be defined as theoretical cycle, that is based on actual properties of cylinder gases. That is theoretical cycle based on actual properties of cylinder contents is called as fuel air cycle. We have to keep this definition in mind. Next, fuel air cycle takes in consideration following things. Actual composition of cylinder contents. Now, what is actual composition? As I said, fuel plus air plus water vapors which are present in air, or residue gases which is also called as exhaust gases. Variation in specific heat of gases in cylinder. There will be complete variation in specific heat, as there will be air temperature will be more than 1600 kelvin and the mixture will be inhomogeneous. Specific heat changes with temperature, exception we can say for monoatomic gases, and hence ratio of specific heat also changes. Dislocation effect. Variation in number of moles also takes place in cylinder with change of pressure and temperature. As I said, due to combustion, the pressure and temperature is very high. Now, next considerations while studying air fuel cycle are as follows. Compression and expansion processes are frictionless. No chemical change in either fuel or air prior to combustion. Combustion takes place instantaneously at top dead center. There is no heat transfer between gases and cylindrical walls, means that the process is adiabatic. Substitute to combustion, the charge or mixture is always in chemical equilibrium. Okay. The basic advantages of air fuel cycle is that when an air cycle is studied, the effect of only compression ratio is taken in consideration, whereas when we study fuel air cycle, we also study effect of compression ratio, fuel air ratio, inlet pressure, temperature and various specific heat and other factor on engine performance. Now we will see composition of cylinder gases. The actual composition of cylinder contains fuel plus air plus water vapors plus residual gases, which is also known as exhaust gases. The fuel air ratio changes during the engine operation. The change in air fuel ratio affects the composition of gases before and after combustion. Priorly, the percentage of CO2, COH2, etc. in exhaust gases, because there is change in composition, hence the percentage of CO2, COH2, etc. changes. The amount of exhaust gases in clearance volume varies with speed and load on engine. The amount of exhaust gases also changes as there is change in speed and load of engine. The amount of exhaust gases in clearance volume also varies with speed and load of engine. The fresh charge composition varies its composition because when it enters in cylinder, it comes in contact with burn gases. Now we will see composition of cylinder gases. In composition of working fluid which changes during the engine operating cycle, the composition changes as cycle proceeds. Now we will see by stroke of SI engine and CI engine process. In intake stroke, in SI engine, air, fuel, recycle exhaust and residual gases. In CI engine, air, recycled exhaust and recycled gases, we can't see their fuel. Okay, in combustion soak, SI engine consists of air, fuel, water, vapor, air, fuel, vapor, recycled exhaust and residual gases. In CI engine, we can see air, recycled exhaust and residual gases. In expansion stroke, we can see that in CI engine, we have composition of CO2, CO, H2, O2, NO, N2, OH, H2O, OH, etc. Whereas in SI engine, we can see composition product consists of CO2, CO, H2, O2, NO, OH, OH, etc. In exhaust stroke, in SI engine, we can see composition products such as N2, O2, CO2, etc. In CI engine, we can observe that composition products consist of mainly N2, CO2, H2O, O2, etc. Now we will see composition of cylinder gases. The effect of cylinder composition on performance of engine can be studied by means of suitable numerical techniques. The computer analysis can produce fast and accurate results. If we want accurate results, we can do computer analysis also. Thus, the air fuel analysis can be done more easily through computer rather than manual calculation or manual solving also. Now we will see comparison of air standard cycle and air fuel cycle. By air standard analysis, it is understood that how efficiency is improved by increasing compression ratio, whereas air standard cycle analysis do not take in consideration the effect of fuel air ratio, because in air standard cycle fuel is not considered. Therefore, thermal efficiency, because the working medium assumed was air, not fuel. In general, we can say that fuel air cycle analysis is used to study the effect of fuel air ratio on engine thermal efficiency. How the peak pressure and temperature during the cycle varies and its influence on many engine operating variables. Fuel air cycle also says that the thermal efficiency will deteriorate as the mixture supplied on engine is enriched. Because of increasing losses due to variable specific heat, enrichment beyond the chemically correct ratio will lead to incomplete combustion. The combustion will be incomplete and loss in thermal efficiency. The incomplete combustion causes loss in thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency will increase as mixture is mainlined. There will be complete combustion. Beyond a certain leaning, the combustion becomes erratic with loss of efficiency. Means the combustion should be such a way that thermal efficiency is obtained. Okay. In general, the maximum efficiency is within lean zone, where near the stoichiometric ratio is obtained. Hence, stoichiometric ratio plays an important role here.